right, so we've talked about AB, ABA, and Rondo. Now let's talk about one that doesn't have any letters in it. The form that we're going to look at now is called theme and variation, or theme and variations. Either way, we talk about both ways. So what we have here is a melody, like an A section, but there's no B, there's no C, there's no nothing else. It's all A. You think, holy moly, that could be boring as possible. You know, how boring could that possibly be? The thing that keeps it from being boring is the variations. Let's look at this in terms of food. I like to talk about food. So you and I are going to have pizza. We're both going to order pizza, but we're going to get the kind of pizza that we like. So there's a pizza-ness to our pizza. We'll assume that we're going to get your traditional round pizza. So we have our round pizza. We can put various toppings on it. It's still going to be a pizza. It's got a crust. It's got some sort of cheese and sauce and whatever. Just everything else is just something slightly different. It's easily recognizable as being a pizza. We could even get a square pizza. And it still looks like a pizza. It's got the elements of pizza-ness to it. So in theme and variation, you've got this theme that we're going to hear at the beginning, and the composer's going to make sure you know it first. And then we're going to make other kinds of pizza out of that theme. So what can composers do to make variations? They could stretch the notes out. They can go into different keys. They could go into different meters. They can go from legato to staccato. Lots of different things. So we're going to look at a theme and variation by Mozart. And I'm not going to play the whole thing. It's really long. But we're going to take a look at the theme and then look at various variations to see how the composer does something different with it. So the thing is, you've really got to get the theme in your head. I'm going to give you an example to listen to that is based on a theme that you will really be familiar with. And I mean, one of those things that you can listen to is Mozart's variations on Twinkle Twinkle, because we know that song really well, and you can look at how he treats that. But there's also a lovely set of variations on When Johnny Comes Marching Home Again. That's a tune that most people will know. And it's not very long, and you don't have to think quite as hard about it as the Mozart, which has 12 variations and lasts a bit longer. So let's listen first to the theme from this Mozart theme and variation set. He does ask to repeat that, but we won't because you get the general idea. So you can see that even in this theme, it's broken down to two contrasting sections, but we still take the whole theme as the theme, just as in When Johnny Comes Marching Home, you take the entire song as being the theme. So that's our opening theme. Now let's look at what he does with the first variation. That's a long way removed from. He started out using a simple duple meter, so our beats were divided in twos. We get to this variation, he's moved it to what we call triplets, where we put three in the place where two would have been. It'll sound like compound meter, but he hasn't actually changed the meter. So everything sort of flows differently. If you listen carefully, you can still hear. You can hear that little pickup part of it going through. So in this particular one, he takes those duple kinds of sounds and makes them sound triple. Here's the next variation. So you think he's just going to do the same thing. He starts out with the little triplets, and then he throws this in. So he goes back into a duple kind of feel. So you've got a contrast now, triple versus duple. And he just carries that on through that particular variation. All right, here's the next variation. You can still hear the same chords. It's still got the same, what we would call a harmonic progression, how we're going from one chord to the next, but lots of extra notes thrown in the middle. So you have a lot of what we might think of as busy work going on. And then we've got this, which we've not had at all, this kind of big bass thing going on. So it gives us something else to listen to. Here's the next variation. Look, we went down there. We haven't been down there on the piano at all. So he's getting kind of dramatic here. We're going to go down here and hit the bottom. And in Mozart's time, that would have been almost the bottom of the piano because the piano has grown a little since then. He puts in these, which we call arpeggios. They're just chords that are broken up with a little bit more notes. The melody is sort of coming back to what we heard in the original. So at least that part is recognizable. All right, let's see what else he might do. Let's go over here. So we skipped over a couple of variations where he does some other things. Now let's listen what happens. Now he's gone to a minor key. So we've been major, major, majoring along. Let's do something different. Let's put it in a minor key. That's a pretty typical thing to do. We go to a minor key, we usually think of sort of a sadder kind of sound, so the melody has changed. It's more dramatic, I think, in some ways. So he does that, and then he takes us back. Still in a minor there. And we end on a lovely minor. But then he goes right back to major. Right back to the same chord structure we've been doing, but now we've got all these nice big octaves and a little bit more drama. So those are things that he could do. You know, we've changed the meter feel. He actually has a variation later where he does go into triple meter for a while. We go into related keys. We go into minor keys. We go from a smooth melody to something that's broken up, staccato to legato. Lots of different contrasting things. You can always find the theme in there if you work really hard at it. Sometimes it gets a little hard. But as you listen, just try to hang on to, in this case, the chords are the best thing to find because those are fairly consistent. The melody, you know, where'd it go? We don't know. But as you listen to the twinkle, twinkle variation, it's pretty easy to find the melody in that because you'll know it really, really well. And you can pay more attention to what he's doing, because it's Mozart again, to make those differences in theme and variation. So remember, it's like we had our pizza party. We all had our own pizzas, but they're all variations on a pizza. So when you go to a concert, if you see a piece that says variations on something or theme and variations on something, you'll know that that's the form you should be listening to. So you should hear the same theme throughout, just done something different to each time it comes along. And you can think about, hey, what did that composer do to make that particular contrast? So that's theme and variation form.